drilling decoys, drilling feints. Like I said, I made Deontay, I bought out his toolbox, and I made him go into everything in his toolbox that he haven't been using. We didn't do these things from a subconscious state. I made sure we got everything out their toolbox, and we drilled it and used it and practiced it every single day with intent. And that's what he did. And I will say this. I will say he's remotivated. He rededicated himself to the sport. He really sacrificed a lot to get what he gonna get on October 9th, man. He deserves it. He really do, man, because...
Hey, and physically, he looks great. Whatever transformation you guys did, because he looks like he's a bit thicker. Mm-hmm. You know, he's always looked like an athlete, but now he looks more like a boxer than a hooper.
Absolutely. And you want to know...
In any bad way.
You know, want to know what that is, too? That's another thing that's a part of the sacrifices he made and the changes, because he brought in Jacqueline as our nutritionist. He, Joey Scott, our strength guy, they went into new levels.
Benching 300 pounds like it's nothing.
Yeah, he's really been eating good and packing on the weight and still working out good. He did. He crossed all T's and dotted all I's in this training camp, man, because this was actually his third camp getting ready for this fight. So, like, when it got postponed, we stayed on board. We gave him some rest off, but I constantly kept his mind active on the task at hand. Even if I was sending him film study, even if I was talking technique with him, like even when we gave him off physically for them few days, I still made sure Boxer remained fresh in his mind. So he's more than ready, man.
Malik,
that's awesome. And I really think that the time off favors him way more so than it favors Fury.
Absolutely.
I really, really believe that.
Absolutely.
Fury needed that. He seemed like, you know, I actually think it would have been the wrong move to jump directly back into the rematch 6 months later. I don't think that was the right move. I think with the time that's passed and all the stuff that you're talking about, it gives him a much better shot at getting the job done. And the heavyweights, boy, you know, the big boys, anything can happen. I don't care who you are, anything can happen, and I'm here for it.
Absolutely, and I'm here for it. Absolutely, man. And Omar, if this Deontay that I'm training continue to stay open-minded, continue to create, continue to be disciplined, continue to work on himself in and out the ring, not only Tyson Fury will be the least of his problems. He'll never lose another fight again because he's already dynamic. I'm just adding tools that he don't even use that he already has, but I'm making sure he use them all every day.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Well, let me tell you, man, I'm going to be the first one tuned in. You're going to have my money in multiple rooms. I'm buying in multiple rooms in the house. So y'all got my cheese, and I really, you know what? I'm really, really excited to see that, and I hope he's bought in, because that's what you're saying.
Absolutely.
And the whole thing about it, as a former athlete, buying into the coach's scheme is essential for victory in every sport.
Absolutely. And like in the magic word, coming in camp, before I trained him, when he asked me to train him, the only thing that I was concerned with is him being receptive. And I wasn't even that concerned with it, because when he asked me to train him, he made himself very clear that he was ready and willing to change any and everything, whatever it is we had to change to get this job done. And he did it, man. He really did it. I didn't have one issue with him in training camp. He's always asked me for more work. He's always wanted to go over film study. He's always nodded his head, gave me eye contact. He's always did what I asked. Like, he's just been, like, you know, it's been a pleasure working with him, not just because I look at him as a brother, but also because I look at it as far as a fighter and teacher student. I couldn't be more proud of the quantum leaps that he's made in training camp. So it's all going to pay off for him. It's all going to pay off for him, man. It really is.
What round is the knockout coming, Malik? What do you think?
I got it happening inside of 5 rounds, and I just don't believe the pace that Deontay has been training at, with the power he has, with the way he disguises the right hand now. So many different things and dimensions he have to him. I just don't see, I can't see Fury making it out of 5 rounds with him right now. But even if he do, and I'm wrong about my prediction of 5 rounds, Deontay Wilder is in enough shape to beat him up for 12 rounds. We'll just beat him up then. We'll just beat him up.
I got to ask you this. You spent years sparring. Check this out, Omar. Malik spent years sparring Usyk. He knows him very well, very close to him. You ever sparred Joshua?
No, we was in the same training camp, but okay. We never sparred.
What happens if rematch? What do you guys think, Joshua Usyk rematch?
I think if Joshua don't make the necessary adjustments collectively with his team, I don't think he need to switch trainers. I don't think that's the go-to with that problem. I think that was a mental issue. When I say a mental issue, I feel as though that things that it take it physically for him to do, positioning wise, to beat a crafty southpaw like Usyk, it's all about positioning. he didn't do that or adjust that night with nothing. Like, it's almost like once he realized that he was in with someone that was extremely more technical, and believe it or not, Usyk, he doesn't punch like Wilder and the bigger guys in the division, but he has a lot of snap at the end of that at the end of those technicality punches he throws. You know what I mean?
So, I heard Chisora say the same thing.
Yeah, it's not like he's some small guy that can't punch. And everybody was blinded because of the okay performances he had against Chisora and Chaz Witherspoon. But they didn't give him the benefit of the doubt and say, well, he is just coming to heavyweight division. Give him some seasoning time. He's so good that they expected him to be spectacular right off the rip. No. He had his two fights. And then now look at this, what he did right here, Omar. Most people that fight Joshua, they need some tough fights in the heavyweight division, then fight him. He fought Joshua, his third fight in the heavyweight division, and his opponent before Joshua was Derek Chisora. It's not like he fought some top one or top two guy, then fought Joshua.
Listen, bro.
He got right in the division and fought Anthony Joshua, and he was chasing Joshua for this fight.
They got to stop the Anthony Joshua slander, first and foremost.
Right.
Because in all honesty, in the heavyweight division, Anthony Joshua's got the best resume out of everybody.
Right.
Because he's fought more dudes that are the dude than anybody. Now, I'll say this. I disagree because what I saw in that fight, I think he does need to change trainers.
Right.
Because of this, because of what you said. Mm. His trainers never had the answer, just like against Ruiz. They never have the answer when he's in trouble. It's always be smart, which is like code for don't get knocked out.
Right.
And the problem is, when you're the bigger man, I don't care what it is. If I'm Tyson Fury and I'm coming in to fight Thrall on Saturday, right?
Yeah.
If I'm Tyson Fury, I'm coming to impose myself on Deontay because he's the smaller man.
Right.
Because this is why they have weight classes.
Right.
Now, in this particular situation, my man decided to try to outbox the arguably the greatest boxer on the planet right now.
Right, right.
Usyk was the best. Another thing that nobody talks about is, and I got the pick wrong too, because I picked Joshua, but nobody talks about how Usyk was low-key the pound-for-pound king for a good 4 years, 3 years, something like that. He never got the credit for it, but nobody was undisputed when he was undisputed.
Nobody. Right, true. Nobody. No, and for him to get undisputed, he beat some quality guys.
He beat quality opponents.
Murat Gesayev in the finals, he put a clinic on. Yeah. Murat is the type of guy that he touches you.
Yes, yes.
So for me, this is what it comes down to. I feel like Anthony Joshua has to commit to his strengths, and it seems to me, if you fight another heavyweight who's a big guy, any traditional heavyweight, Anthony Joshua's got problems for them because he's real big, he's skilled, and yada, yada. Usyk is smaller than him. Ruiz is smaller than him.
Oh, no. Oh, yeah. That's a very, very good eye, Omar. That's a very good eye of you.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
I know exactly what you're saying.
He knows his stuff. Omar knows his stuff.
He's got a problem for you because he got heavy hands.
Right.
He got thunder in both hands, and he's a big old dude.
And Omar, you got to realize, when he fought Dillon White the first time, Dillon White hurt him, but Dillon White is under him as well.
Hey, this is what I'm trying to tell
height-wise,
you.
Height-wise, Dillon is under him.
We've only seen him have problems with two people. Mm. I mean, he's beat quality guys. So right. Everybody, I know what the heavyweight game, I know the boxing game, you know, you got to put down your opponent and yada, yada, and everybody calls him the bodybuilder, blah, blah, blah. Let me tell you something, man. Anthony Joshua puts people to sleep.
Right.
Straight up.
He got some good knockouts. He got a couple good knockouts.
And he had some good technical wins. That win against Joseph Parker was a great technical win.
Yeah.
That was a nice boxing clinic.
Yeah, but a lot of people, so you got to realize, like, Omar, like, my favorite fights from Joshua isn't the fights where he knocked out people. I like the Anthony Joshua that got the title back from Ruiz. I could watch AJ box like that all day. I could watch any big
and
man.
And it's beautiful.
And right? It's beautiful to me, beautiful. Yeah. Now,
the AJ
I think that you thought was going to show up, I don't think he even showed up. The AJ that you think would have beat Usyk, that's not the AJ that showed up.
At all.
Right.
And this is my you're making my point. My point is, and I know I go extreme, but honestly, he either needs to get with a new team or that team needs to make him commit to his strengths, or he should just ride off into the sunset with his $300-400 million and keep it pushing.
I'm going to say this. That's a good three options for him. And I think out of those three, I think I'm serious too. And make sure you zone in on that, Ellie. I want AJ to hear that, because if I had to say he had three options, and I know he his own man, he can his own career dude, but this ain't even casual talk, because Omar, I could tell he doesn't have, this is not coming
he from knows his shit.
He knows yep. his shit. This is not coming from a casual space. Those three options that Omar just said, in my opinion, that's where AJ is at as far as getting the title back right now. It's one of those three. Your team have to make you commit to being who you really are. Your team have to make some, you have to get a new team, or you could just ride off into the sunset. But the adjustments have to be made.
Okay.
There's got to be adjustments to be made.
Yep.
And you don't lose nothing, by the way, you don't lose nothing by riding off into the sunset. You're a young dude. You got all the money in the world. You have all the adoration. There is no bigger star in boxing than him. And Canelo's a giant, but there's no big, Anthony Joshua is a, man, this dude, forget about it.
In England.
He's selling crazy numbers.
In England.
In England. If I take him to Bakersfield, nobody's going to know him, Omar. But they'll know Canelo.
I agree.
But let me tell you something. If you take him to Pac Bell Stadium in San Francisco, it'll sell out.
I don't think
you
so.
You can take him anywhere, and it's going to say, oh, man, y'all lost your mind.
Listen, Canelo's popular. Gervonta Davis is popular. Manny Pacquiao's popular. Joshua's popular in the UK.
Manny just retired. I'm not saying Canelo's not popular. He just sold out his 70,000 seats in the middle of the pandemic. Yeah.